Yo, what's up, everybody? The heck is this movie at? I know I'm gonna entitle this The Last Dragon, right? There it is. The Last Dragon. I'm trying to. Alright, so it came out in March 22nd, 1985. So I was 5 years old when this movie came out. They had the nerve to give it. It looks like 4.5 stars. No, my friend. No. The IMDb gives it a 6.9. No, my fr out of a 10. No, my friend. No. Listen to this. I just added to the liked on it, right? If I could, it won't let me. There it is. It says 92%. People like this movie that are Google users. So that goes to show you how out of touch the movie industry with this IMDb and also, yes, IMDb, they're giving them a low rating. Listen. 92% of people like this movie that are Google users. Think about that. I don't know how many people that is, but I know it's a lot, right? This movie is the hottest movie that has ever hit. The Last Dragon, Leroy Green, was and still is. He's our black superhero. It's Leroy Green. There is one place, and it is there, only there. That you shall find the master. There's so many lines in this movie, but this movie teaches a lot of morals. It teaches the fact that you can find the answers within yourself. It teaches to be determined. It has morals in it. This teaches principles. Stick to what you know, it'll get you through. Leroy freaking whoop, showing off ass, showing off was cocky. Am I the prettiest? Sure enough. Am I the meanest? Sure enough. Am I the baddest foe low down around this town? I know some of y'all could quote this movie better than me, but I looked at Sure Enough like the world. Sure Enough wanted the world wants us to bow down to your master. And some of us ain't bowing down, man. I give The Last Dragon. Now, let me explain something to you about The Last Dragon, right? If you never heard of this movie, The Last Dragon, I only have 241 subscribers. Out of those 241, bet you a bunch of them are robots, and the other half ain't nobody listening. There might be one person that'll hear this video. That one person, if you don't know The Last Dragon, get to know that movie. And if you don't get to know that movie, if you tell me you don't like it, just unsubscribe. Just do it, because I don't care. I'm gonna tell you right now, this movie is I'm the big Last Dragon fan. I'm gonna find out when's the next time he's gonna do a public showing. I want to shake this guy's hand and let him know that I love his movie. It played a big part in my life as a kid. We used to play karate, me and my brothers, and we used to act like we were playing different parts of the movie. And I mean, Eddie Arcadian. I mean, trying to take over the music industry, Eddie Arcadian trying to take over the music industry. He couldn't do it. You know why? Because Bruce Leroy, he figured he could shoot Bruce Leroy. He couldn't shoot Bruce Leroy. Bruce Leroy caught a bullet with his teeth. He caught a bullet with his teeth. Even Eddie Arcadian, all right? They call him Mr. Biggs in other movies, if you know what I mean. I'm gonna get you, sucker. You know what I mean? He tried to kill Bruce Leroy. But because he had reached the final level, you will know by having a glow all over your body. Because he reached that final level, because Bruce Leroy reached that final level, bro, he caught the bullet with his teeth. And even Shownuff was even big. Come on, man. Somebody know what I'm talking about? Check this out. Shownuff is so big. His ego got so big, he whooped everybody that he could whoop, that he ended up getting. You think he wasn't in pursuit of the glow? Shownuff was in pursuit of the glow. The only thing with that glow with Shownuff is that he... And Shownuff is a better actor than Bruce Leroy in some cases, because he's very cocky. And sometimes people love cocky, especially with the football freaking spiked up freaking shoulder pads and stuff. You know? And he looked hot to this day. The dude was tall. He fight. He never smiled. Serious as heck. He was a man's man. He was after something and he pursued it and he got it. You hear what I'm saying? So both people, both the bad guy and the good guy, both pursued after something and they got it. The one guy, and he even got what he wanted, Eddie Arcadian. He invested in the scene of the century, a fight of the century. Bruce Leroy between all of the worst thugs and the baddest people that you could ever see. But the only problem with Eddie Arcadian is he wanted to be on top. That was the highest he got. The one guy, I can't think of his name right now, my bad. But the one guy, the great white hopeless they called you, him. He wanted to shoot Bruce Leroy and end it all. And then Eddie said, don't shoot him. Don't shoot him. You see, you know how much I got invested in this? He invested so much to set up Bruce Leroy. He kidnapped his woman. He got everybody out there because he was mad because he embarrassed him. He got everybody out there just to whoop him in his own game. You got to respect that. You got to respect that even out of Eddie Arcadian. Who is this? Barry Gordy was the producer of this movie. Listen, man. This movie was literally the hottest movie for decades and decades and decades and years to come. You know, it's almost as though they hit Super Saiyan level. You know how it is. They did hit Super Saiyan level. Think about it. Just think about it for a second. This glow is a glow that even Goku and Vegeta try to hit. When they get into their modes, they have a glow over their body. Well, this mug went... Bruce Leroy went Super Saiyan, man. How would you not like this movie? That's all I'm trying to say. It's literally the hottest movie ever. That's what I'm trying to tell you. If you don't like it, get your mind checked out. One of the most entertaining movies of my time. I love it. And I'll share a quick story with you and I'll be done. So I've been watching this movie ever since I was a young lad. I was born in a little around this time. So this story was very influential. And also to the fact that there's not many black superheroes. If not, there was none at the time. We had Conan around the 1985s. But Bruce Leroy, that's a whole nother level. If you ask me which movie I want to see, Bruce Leroy or Conan, my mom had the VHS tape. We would have said, we watched Conan like crazy. I ain't going to lie. Conan the Barbarian with the sword and stuff. But once Bruce Leroy came, we were fanatics. We became, it's one thing when you just watch something and you go, oh, wow, that's crazy. And you play with the sword. That's one thing. But it's another thing when you actually become Bruce Leroy, when you feel like you are this dude and like you're just playing the scene in the movie. And you're doing everything that he could do in the movie, but you're a kid. Oh my gosh, it was just so much fun. I would walk around my school just acting, thinking the mindset of Bruce Leroy. You know what I'm saying? That's why it's really nice to have good movies with people in it that look like you, because you can relate to that person. That's what it's all about. It's a cultural thing. And, oh my gosh. So, Bruce Leroy, this is not the first, this is not going to be the last visit that I have with this. I'm going to talk about it later on. In fact, I'll share the story on the next, I'll share the story about Bruce Leroy on my next, my next video when I need to get a break from politics and religion and all that stuff, which I'm taking my little break right now. So I just wanted to talk about Bruce Leroy Green with the Kung Fu Dojo in Harlem and also my man Shownuff, which is actually the hottest guy too. He's the Shogun of Harlem. Ain't nobody hotter than these two guys, man. I was so mad and sad to hear the Bruce Leroy passed away, and also this fine, sexy lady, I can't think of her name right now, excuse me, but I know the big fans are like, you ain't no fan, but I'm looking at the videos and all of the different scenes. Laura Charles, I would like to see her. Laura Charles said she'd like to see me. She said it was a pleasure to see me. You know that part. Leroy, I'm afraid of the dark. Even that guy was funny. But Laura Charles, oh my gosh, if I could meet her. She passed away. But if I could meet her just one day in my life, I'd be happy. I don't care how old she is. She killed that movie. She way finer than Beyonce. Way finer than all the singers. Well, except for I do have one singer that I have a crush on. And that is Alicia Keys. I've always had a little crush on Alicia Keys. But that girl, man. I found a place. I finally found a place for you. And where did you go to fit in? Ha ha. Step on the elevator. Press number 7. I'm like, okay, let me get on that elevator with you now. But my man Leroy, he got in there. He don't even know how to use a paintbrush. Leroy got in it. And the ending was beautiful as well. What a beautiful ending. It almost looked like a wedding. They were just together and balloons. The bouquet was tossed up in the air. They were hugging each other. They were smiling. Everybody was wearing white. It was like a big celebration party. All the bad guys are gone and all the good people were together. I mean, how could you not like this movie? Anytime when I hear someone say that they have a friend, right? And the friend does not like The Last Dragon, I get annoyed just by hearing that. That's how much of I like this movie. But anyway, I understand everybody thinks differently. Everybody's entitled to their own opinion. I think this movie played a big part in my life. I love it. I love Bruce Leroy. And yeah. How did you know that was the blue one? I do not know. You do not know. Forgive me, Master. I will do anything to. Yeah, the movie is hot, man. So, to all my peoples out there, get to, you know, subscribing and liking this channel. You'll understand the mindset of a young black man that has lived the American dream and still trying to do so in the middle of COVID. We talk about cars. We talk about movies. I talk about politics. I talk about religion. I'm well-rounded in every topic, baby. But on this topic today, shout out to Bruce Leroy Green and the whole entire crew. Shout out to the mom, the pop with the deliver your pizza to Daddy Green's pizza. Shout out to the kid, his brother. You know, told Bruce Leroy when he got thrown in the garbage, his brother, he said, why don't you go somewhere and meditate on that? You kissed his shoes and everything, coward. So anyway, you get the point. I am a big fan. I love this movie. Stay tuned. More to come. Peace.